Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. In the name of Allah, the Most Gracious, the Most Merciful. May the peace and blessings of the Almighty be upon every one of us. We also commence sending blessings and salutations upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his household, his companions, and may Allah bless every single one of us. My brothers, my sisters, you and I know we follow the lunar calendar. This lunar calendar, we look out for the moon, or should I say the crescent, the new moon. And the month commences and ends based on the sightings of the moon. Okay. Now, subhanAllah, we have 12 months in the calendar, in the year. Where did we get that from? Well, we got it from Allah Almighty. He tells us, إِنَّ عِدَّةَ الشُّهُورِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ 12 شَهْرًا فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ يَوْمَ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ مِنْهَا أَرْبَعَةٌ حُرُمٌ ذَلِكَ الدِّينُ الْقَيِّمُ. الله أكبر. Allah says, when Allah created the heavens, or should I say the skies and the earth, He decided that in the year there will be 12 months. And from among those 12 months, there will be 4 months that are haram. What is the meaning of 4 months being haram? Well, Allah says there will be a year. In the year, there will be 12 months. And from those months, there will be four which are considered prohibited months. Why does he say haram? Haram to do what? Haram to go to war, even if it's a legitimate war. Haram to commence hostilities. Haram to do anything that is hurtful, harmful. But you need to realize, one might argue that, well, a lot of these things are haram anyway through the year. Correct. A lot of them are haram through the year, but it becomes more important to become conscious of the prohibition of these things, especially during the prohibited months, or al-ashhurul hurum, the haram months. So sometimes people go to war for a legitimate reason. Allah says, not in these months. However, if someone were to attack you during these months, you have a right to defend yourself, even in these months. And the same would apply if there is harm that is coming to you during the month, you can protect yourself or defend yourself. No problem. But don't commence. That's called the haram months. So I hope we've understood it. Now, from among these months, Allah says four are different. What does this show you? Not all the months are the same. You know, Ramadan is a month that is the best month of the Islamic year when it comes to reward and virtue and so on. MashaAllah, it's the best month as a month from among the 12 months. But there are different seasons. For example, I've given you the haram months. I've told you about Ramadan being the most sacred month. Then I want to tell you about the months of Hajj. The months of Hajj are actually 3 months. The first being immediately after Ramadan. You just fasted that whole season. Allah gave you a day of Eid and He wants you to prepare for another climax of worship. And that will happen in Dhul-Hijjah, which is the last month of the year. But the run-up to it starts immediately after Ramadan, because your intention for the Hajj and the pilgrimage should already be made in most cases. It's not necessary to have been made, but in most cases. And then the journey commences in the next month, which is Dhul-Qi'dah, in most cases. In some cases, perhaps earlier, perhaps a little bit later, in Dhul-Hijjah, which is the last month. So between those 3 months, the Hajj will be full, you know, you commence with the preparation, the intention, the preparation, the journeying, and so on. And then the climax. The climax happens in Dhul-Hijjah, and then Allah gives you another Eid immediately after that season of worship. Just like He gave you an Eid at the beginning where Ramadan took place, and immediately after Ramadan, just at the beginning of the months of Hajj, you started off Shawwal with a day of Eid, the first of Shawwal.
So this is Allah, and it's a gift from Allah. Not all the days are the same. Not all the months are the same. Allah has the haram months and the months of Hajj and the most blessed month. Your acts of worship will be considered differently in these months. Inshallah, I wish to talk about the acts of worship and the virtues of some of these months, the differences between the days and the months. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us goodness, and may Allah open our doors. We are blessed to be within these beautiful days, and we ask Allah to grant us the ability to do the most so that we can please Him. أقول قولي هذا وصلى الله على نبينا محمد.